ACC basketball is being brought to you by Food Lion. Life's better with a lion. By Geico, saving people money for over 75 years. And by your local Toyota dealers. Toyota, let's go places.
Virginia Tech 10-5, 2-0 in the ACC. 14th ranked Duke 13-2, 2-0 in the ACC. And the Blue Devils have it first. Your officials today: Tim Clackerty, Jeffrey Anderson, Wally Rutecki.
You know, Tim, we talked about the league in the open, and Duke very fortunate to come out of Wake Forest with a win.
Ingram starts just the way you said he would, Mike.
Well, I tell you what, he's expanded his game. He feels very comfortable with the three-point shot now. He's so good off the dribble, I'm almost unguardable. And this is what the drive and pitch does for you. It gets you an open shot, and Grayson Allen a little bit of a bump there to give Ingram some room to shoot.
Ingram a 37% shooter from beyond the arc. Allen looked at it, now penetrates, kicks it back. Here he is again. Bang!
You know, at his length, he can shoot over just about anybody that's playing him. And two shots from the exact same spot, that left wing.
Biz pushes it underneath. Henry banks it in, and Virginia Tech is on the board.
He's already exceeded his season average. They don't get a lot of offense from him, but playing off the drive, and that's what you have to guard against Virginia Tech. Very important that Duke guards without fouling in this game. They got into severe foul trouble against Wake Forest.
Here's a foul. Going to be called on Jalen Hudson. That's his first. Mike, our Carolina four keys to the game look like this.
Yeah, I think for Virginia Tech, transition defense first and foremost is a very explosive offensive team for Duke. And then for Duke, match the energy and size of Virginia Tech. They play hard for 40 minutes, and they've got some good size up front.
Grayson Allen knocks down a three ball, and Duke 3-for-3 beyond the arc.
Yeah, 3-for-3, 9 points. That's efficient offense.
Hudson kicks it back out. Well, Bibbs gave up on it, started going down court, never chased his rebound. Grayson Allen is fouled. Foul will be on Hudson.
And he's going to learn the ability on that one, when he hears the whistle, to get the ball up on the rim so he gets a couple of free throws. But to see the good pick right there. I mean, as a defense, you can't let a direct pass come into a guy like that from an open three.
Mike, the bad news for Virginia Tech: Jalen Hudson has two quick personal fouls. He goes out, Justin Robinson comes in. Grayson Allen has that great lean when he drives, draws the personals. Ball got away from Allen. And Seth Allen threw up a wild shot. It starts another transition for Duke. This is going to be a block.
You know, if there's anybody,
that's going to be on LeDay.
If there's anybody at Virginia Tech that should be comfortable in this environment, it's Allen, who is the transfer from Maryland and has played here. And here's the look. And this Duke team has been very aggressive. Some threes early, but now they've started to drive the ball, trying to put some pressure on that defense from Virginia Tech.
Plumlee tried to free up underneath. Again for three. The bonus fear belongs to the Blue Devils.
4-of-4 now from behind the arc.
What a start. Seth Allen takes it at the basket and banks it in.
Plumlee, one of the better shot blockers in the ACC, but what you do with a shot blocker, you drive it right at his chest. He does not want to get in any early foul trouble.
Derek Thornton works it to the right. And Ingram down to the baseline is forced to give it up to Plumlee. And there's a whistle and a foul. Plumlee is fouled.
You got to understand, he's a left-handed shooter. And going in, not afraid of the contact. The Hokies desperately needed.
Seth Allen, as you said, the transfer from Maryland. Three times he's gone 20 points or more this year already.
Buzz Williams there. It's taken him a while. You kind of saw what was coming, and he had two key players that couldn't play last year in LeDay and Allen. So he knew what he was going to have this year, but they didn't have a great non-conference success. They were 8-5, but so far undefeated in the ACC.
Marshall Plumlee puts it down. He's only a 56% free throw shooter, but he's been really playing well lately.
He's playing with a whole new confidence level over the last 5 games.
Down by 10, but keep in mind the Hokies came from 16 down against NC State. His foul is going to be against Shane Henry, and that'll be his second.
See, this is what I'm talking about with, you know, with Ingram. The jump shots are going to set up his drive. So now you've got to come out, guard him on the three, and a 6'8" guy, he's going to be able to take him off the bounce anytime he wants.
Ingram, a 64% free throw shooter. Solid player.
I would say the concern with him as the ACC season unfolds, Tim, is since Emile Jefferson is out, Ingram's forced to guard power forwards, guys who are a little bit more physical than he is, and will that wear him down over the remaining 16 games?
How about this, Mike? Virginia Tech, 5 team fouls already. Duke, none. Duke couldn't have asked for a better start against Virginia Tech.
They could be shooting in the penalty in about 3 or 4 minutes the way they're going.
Hokies 2-0, Blue Devils 2-0. Seth Allen lost it.
Too much dribbling that time, not enough passing.
Taken away by Jones, takes it back up for the reset to Thornton.
Look how the Blue Devils are spaced out there. They're playing around Plumlee. He pulls out, and he's a screener now. The lanes are wide open.
Jones sees the shot clock, works it. Thornton looks for a shot, kicks it back. Allen's got to let it go. Used every bit of the clock. Robinson takes it down Main Street and has it blocked away by Plumlee. This is for 3. How about that, Mike?
Yeah, the length of Ingram again, just being able to reach up, barely jumped off the floor that time, but a 7'3" wingspan and playing on the anticipating where that miss was going to come.
Well, when you're 6'9 and have a 7'3" wingspan, that's impressive. This is Bibbs, and Bibbs has fouled the first foul of the afternoon on Duke. Timeout on the floor. 15-4 Duke out of the blocks. We'll be back. The game for the Blue Devils in the last 3 wins, including game high 25 and last Saturday's win at Boston College. He was the rookie of the week. He's from Kinston, North Carolina.
I'd go out on a stretch, Tim, and say it probably won't be the last time those two guys win that award.
Yeah, That's not that much of a stretch, partner.
But look at the they've combined for 13 of the 15 points, and 7 of the 8 field goal attempts that Duke has had in this game have been from behind the arc.
Bibbs, a 60% free throw shooter, hit 1 of 2. Foul was on Grayson Allen, as you know. Jones.
Virginia Tech in the zone right now, trying to help out in the foul situation.
You can see Jones getting ready for that shot. He wanted the ball back. Here's Seth Allen's going to take it all the way down the paint and score.
Well, Ingram not a bad shot blocker, but with Plumlee out of there, the lane looks more open, and Allen has been very aggressive getting to that left hand.
Got a little bit quiet in here when Duke jumped out to the big lead. This foul is also against Virginia Tech. Kerry Blackshear will be called for his first personal. But this is the way Virginia Tech plays. Virginia Tech plays, they fall behind. They fell behind by 16 to NC State. But they just stay in a ball game. They never go away. They're relentless.
Well, and Mike Krzyzewski said, talked to us and told us before the game, it's kind of the attributes of a Buzz Williams coach's team. Playing hard for 40 minutes, very physical.
This kid can flat out shoot. Ingram now has double figures, 10 points. Average is 16, and we still have 14:40 to play in the first half.
Yeah, 10 points in 5 minutes.
Robinson gives him a little extra quickness. Crossover, all alone. This is beyond the arc and no good. Lede had a good look. He's averaging 31% from beyond the arc, but didn't seem close on that shot. Ingram on the baseline, got a little out of control. Back up top, Allen. He draws iron.
I think the thing that Duke has to be, you know, they've shot the ball extremely well, but maybe start now mixing in some drives, even though you're working against the zone, but to be a little bit more aggressive. There you see Ingram just kind of lurking behind Marshall Plumlee, which is a good screen right there. The pop, direct pass, and didn't matter which side of the floor he's shooting on, he's seeing a big basket. Seth Allen trying to bring Virginia Tech back single-handedly.
He wanted the foul. He did get hit. No call.
Jacket already off early for Buzz Williams.
You mentioned Allen's played in this building before when he was at the University of Maryland. That's the way this college game seems to be going with graduates and guys transferring.
I do my boards in pencil now.
How about that? Doesn't take him long. Luke Kennard with a three.
Last 10, averaging 15 points a game, has really stepped it up. I really love his attitude. Rebounds the ball extremely well for his size.
He's gone 20 plus twice off the bench. You know, Quinn Cook and Tyrus Jones, they're gone now. Duke needed a point guard, so Coach K told Luke Kennard, start working on your ball handling before he got here to Duke. He's a good looking player. Here he is with the rebound and the push.
The day has been quiet in this game so far.
How about this start by Duke? Matt Jones knocks down another. Duke was the first ACC team to get a road. Look at Mike Krzyzewski, 68 years old, 5 NCAA national championships. How about this? 46.2% of all wins in Duke men's basketball history belong to that man. Wearing a knee brace on his left knee, he's got a little flat tire, a little hitch in his giddy up. Blackshear knocks down that shot. That'll help.
Yeah, good timeout by Buzz Williams, and he knows the crowd's going. Got them quieted down a little bit. He's got to keep this game in shape. But how about this number for Duke? 7 field goals, 7 threes, and 7 assists.
Whistle and foul. Foul's very disproportionate here so far. That one's on Devin Wilson, his first. So now they're already in the bonus.
Well, that's a product of Duke being aggressive off the dribble. I mean, you kind of force the referees in. Buzz Williams is doing a little lobbying over there on the sideline.
Luke Kennard at the line. 93% free throw shooter. Money at the line. Now hit 54 of his 58 free throws this year. He's got 4 points today.
He really came in, was a big reason why Duke got that win over Winston-Salem and Marshall Plumlee in that fourth quarter, second period.
Makes them both. 26-9. Draws iron. Plumlee with the rebound. Starts it the other way. Got a kick out of Mike before the game. Coach Krzyzewski. Coach K telling us, painting the moon blue about, you know, we're not a great team. We're okay.
Yeah, well,
we're on 11-2 runs.
He also said, you know, made mention of the fact of a noon start, which I didn't like early starts. It took me a while to get going. He said, I know Virginia Tech will show up. I hope we do. Well, I think he's answered that question.
No bucket offensive. Matt Jones, his second. 26 stationed around the globe in 175 countries and on the high seas. So proud to have you with us today.
Speaking about around the globe, good friend of mine, Eric Savage, who lives with his family, is watching in India right now. He's a regular at the K Academy, so we are worldwide, partner.
And we're glad to have him along. Hudson, stop, pop, can't get it to go down.
Aside from a Seth Allen drive, there have really been no easy buckets for Virginia Tech in this first half.
Allen with the turnaround. Nice job by Plumlee to knock it out. Blackshear, Wilson. Devin Wilson to the foul line, drops it off. Blackshear runs into a whole lot of trouble.
I don't know that Marshall Plumlee might have gotten a piece of that.
Grayson Allen turns it over. Ahead to Hudson. That bucket will count, and Hudson will go to the line for one more.
That's one of the first easy runouts that Virginia Tech has had. They get the turnover on one end, and then everybody a little scrambled defensively getting back. And these are the things you have to do, and this is a good take inside.
Luke Kennard picks up his first personal. And Hudson is only a 61% free throw shooter. He's only hit 29 of his 47 attempts this year.
And let's keep an eye on him, Tim, because remember, he's got those two personal fouls, so he's got to be smart the way he plays. Let's see whoever he's guarding if they're a little more aggressive off the dribble.
Looks pretty good on that one, converting the three-point play. Makes it 26-12. Right now, the Hokies just trying to get that lead back down into single digits.
You got to get into that play this game in 4-minute increments. Try to win each 4 minutes going into half and carve in that lead.
This is a foul fest for the Hokies. This one caught on Justin Bibbs. That's his first. But they are in the bonus, so Derek Thornton goes to the line. He'll be shooting 1-1, 74% free throw shooter. Graduated early so he could get over here to Duke and get into the rotation, get into practice, and it's paid off.
And they needed him with Tyus Jones going to the making the decision to go into the draft. They were thin at point guard, so a lot of responsibility. And I think he was feeling in his way a very tough position to come in as a freshman and dominate at. But he's feeling his way, and I think feeling more comfortable.
You know, I used to say when a kid like Derek Thornton from California comes all the way over here to Durham, it's a big adjustment. But they travel so much now in AAU and travel teams and everything else, it's no big deal anymore. They're all so mature and experienced by the time they get here. Here's Hudson looking for help. Drives it down the middle, and he's fouled.
Yeah, good bit. It's the first one they were able to pick up on Plumlee.
Hudson looked good on his last free throw. Let's see how he does here. 6'1", 180-pound freshman from Manassas, Virginia.
Well, if you're Virginia Tech, if you can slow the game down a little bit, get to the free throw line, score some points there, and it would be a huge bonus for them if they can pick up the second foul on Plumlee.
Hudson had only 2 points against Virginia Monday night. Just kind of disappeared. He's apt to do that, but then he'll light it up from what did Mike Krzyzewski called him, a microwave. He's got 5 points here today.
Virginia Tech's been in a lot of zone since early in this half, and that's the thing. If you're Duke right now, you can't become happy with your jump shot.
That's a carry by Seth Allen. He saw a pass, an entry pass he wanted to make, and then hesitated as it closed up.
I'll know it's a real game if Buzz Williams takes the vest off. Then we'll know. Then you know things are really heating up.
Buzz Williams, 43 years old, coached at Marquette, did a terrific job there to Blacksburg and Virginia Tech here in the ACC, won the Big East regular season championship.
And Steve Wojciechowski, assistant here, took over there and has had some pretty good success, 11-4 so far, although 1-2 in conference.
You know, you look at all the Duke guys that are now head coaches around college basketball, and not one of them has ever beaten Mike Krzyzewski. Plumlee misses from close range, goes up again and slams it home.
That's a play that he couldn't have made 2 years ago. I mean, he's just got so much confidence and he plays with a lot of fire. And more importantly, he's a great talker on the defensive end of the floor.
The Hokies turn it over again. Blackshear throws it away. Four turnovers for Virginia.
See, the first one really was lucky that it came to him. He went up a little too strong that time. But staying with the play, overpowering the front line for Virginia Tech.
Really been dominant here, the Blue Devils. Ingram wants that shot, kicks it back out though.
That's the play where they give him that isolation on the left side, but they shadowed him with a guy in the lane and he couldn't drive.
Underneath to Plumlee.
18 points against Wake Forest in the last game. And that's what he does best, off the drives, gets his hands ready to receive and finish.
He got a lot of those when Thompson was out of the game. This is offensive. Lede threw out the chicken wing.
Well, you know what? For all the threes that Brandon Ingram has made in this game, this play excites Mike Krzyzewski more than anything on the offensive floor to see his freshman step in and draw a foul.
Well, I don't know. There's a look at Mike Krzyzewski, now 68 years old. Five NCAA national championships.
In three different decades. That's the thing, to be energized that long.
I think back to last March and we're doing the ACC championship game. Duke wasn't in it. They go on and win the national title.
Well, they haven't won it, Duke or North Carolina, in the last 5 years.
I know. Amazing. Seth Allen picks up his first personal. Uphill climb now for Virginia Tech. They've dug a pretty good hole. Grayson Allen makes his first. Largest lead of the night, or the afternoon. Feels like night. Good night. See how Virginia Tech responds to what looks like a knockout punch by Duke early.
That's the thing, for a noon game, I mean, your whole preparation day is shortened. And you really have to lock in mentally and physically, get a good warm up, and then Duke just came out quickly.
Nice pass by Hudson underneath, and Blackshear buries it. Blackshear with 4 points.
For Virginia Tech, you need somehow a nice drive with the left hand there. Get this under double figures going into the locker room. That would be a win.
They did come from 16 down against NC State, but that was in the castle. This is going to be an offensive foul. Justin Robinson just can't do anything right. Grant Hill loving it. One of the all-time great night coach with Bobby Knight. Won the Distinguished Graduate Award at West Point. Everything he's done his entire life has been quality.
Yeah, with purpose and with an eye toward excellence. And you know, last year's freshman team was really special. This year's team, different. And Mike says just a lot of pressure on them. They're not, you know, there's not a lot of room for error. Great analogy that he made. He said there's no food in the refrigerator. Everything we have is out on the table.
It's pretty good, and they're getting better and better each game. I mean, when you look around this lineup, Allen's one of the old guys and a sophomore. But when you look at the other guys, I mean, you're talking about Kennard and Ingram and Thornton, all freshmen, true freshmen.
You know, well, Plumlee is a graduate student, and you got Matt Jones as a junior. Those are your senior lead. That's your upperclassman leadership.
Kick it into the corner.
And that's one of the, if not the biggest reason why they miss Jefferson so much.
Kerry Blackshear makes that shot, and it helps a little bit, but that's going to be a foul at the other end. They just can't get anything going here. Look at Emile Jefferson out injured. Every bucket inside now is important with him out since his injury. And Kennard, since his injury, has gone 24 points, 18 points, 9 points, 17 points. Freshmen have really picked it up with Emile on the bench.
You know, when they say, when you say bench player, you got to look at the minutes that Kennard is playing. You know, all seven guys are playing starter minutes basically.
Right.
There's no real, like, you know, 10-minute guy in the rotation. Jeter maybe, you know, but even his minutes are inching up.
Grayson Allen misses the second one as well. 35-16. The Duke Blue Devils lead at Cameron Indoor Stadium this afternoon. There's a whistle away from the ball.
Yeah, this that freedom of movement call, and Blackshear trying to establish the post, and Jeter was riding his hip all the way across.
Chase Jeter picks up his first.
And the 15 foul for Duke, so there's still two away.
So they're going to take another look, see if this is flagrant. Sarcastic smile from Mike Krzyzewski.
I might have missed something. I didn't see anything that looked flagrant. That's the one. You get your elbow
up high. Even if it's accidental, if that elbow is up high, they're going to call it.
Yeah, anything above the chest, though, they might look at it. Talking to Mike, it was interesting. I said, you know, one of the challenges, not just game day, but what do you do in practice? And he said, you know, it's been a real challenge. We can't do a lot of contact drills. Just a week ago or so, Matt Jones rolled his ankle, and everybody's heart went into their throat when that happened. And he was not himself against the Wake Forest team. Did not have a good game, 1 of 8 from the floor. But they just can't do a lot of contact right now.
Emil Jefferson's fracture in his foot was a break, wasn't it? Wasn't a stress fracture?
Yeah, no,
right?
It was a break. Yeah, and that's why
it's hard to come back from.
Yeah. Yeah, they looked at it, and there was no intent there, and so good work by the officials reviewing the play.
There's a look at Emil Jefferson again on the bench,
and I just feel so badly for him to have this happen in his senior year. I just hope for his sake that he can get back and finish out the end of the season and help this team in the tournament.
Allen gets it on the run, pushes it the other way, takes it all the way home.
Well, people underestimate his speed and athleticism, and he gets out in the open floor and gets to his right hand. It's almost an automatic two. Well, almost, you know, and more times than not, it's a dunk.
Grayson Allen now in double figures. Into the corner, Hudson for three. Boy, Duke has taken charge of the boards as well.
How about this?
Ingram.
Duke 7 of 15 from 3 now. Virginia Tech 0 of 6.
Keep in mind now, they started 4 for 4. There's a good follow by Blackshear. Kerry Blackshear now has 6 points.
He's their leading scorer. He's giving them some good minutes.
So since they started 4 for 4, what are they, 3 for 15, you said?
Yeah, and it's,
there's a little travel. Derek Thornton dragged his pivot foot.
You know, Kennard can bring it out of the backcourt. Ingram can. Grayson Allen shows that he can. When you have multiple guys, not just your point guard, who can bring it from the backcourt into the front court and finish, that's a very explosive team. I'll tell you, there are 5 teams in Conference 10 that are averaging over 80 points a game. There's a lot of firepower in the conference this year.
Well, you said it right in the beginning of the telecast. I mean, every game this year is going to be contested. We'll see if the Hokies can climb back into this one.
And Plumlee, since that first foul, has been, you know, he's been standing there vertical, but he has not been looking to block shots, not wanting to pick up that second foul.
It's going to be on Blackshear. And that's his second. Buzz Williams just trying to stop the onslaught.
He's going to have a mental health session with his team at halftime to get their confidence back in the first 4 minutes. You know, this, you don't know how out of shape this game is going to get. Could be 19 after this next free throw.
Marshall Plumlee, the 7-footer from Warsaw, Indiana, makes the first. He's only a 56% free throw shooter, but look good on that one. Makes them both. He's been on a tear, hasn't he, Mike?
He's really been rebounding the ball well, playing good defense, directing, communicating things from the back line.
Boy, Blackshear is not even close for those threes that he's fired up. There's a reason they're leaving him wide open.
Blackshear 18% from three on the year, so I don't know that that's a shot that Buzz Williams wants him taking consistently.
No, that's right. That's my point. There's a reason they're leaving him that wide open. And a good follow inside by Luke Kennard. He's got 7 points.
He gives you 4 rebounds at that position. Pretty good, especially on the offensive glass.
21-point lead for the Blue Devils. One thing the Hokies were able to do was take care of the basketball in their wins over NC State and Virginia the last two outings.
Here's the look against the smaller players. He can be a little bit more aggressive. This is his finish about 3 or 4 minutes ago on his own rebound.
Too many for Kennard, who walked once he got in the lane. This is what you were talking about, Mike.
And this is still first half. You know, that used to be 2 games for him, you know, a couple of years ago.
Well, he doesn't make it look easy, like his brothers did at some points.
Yeah, but he just, you know, he had so many injury issues early in his career. Enforced, and those are the ones you really have to avoid. Those unforced turnovers, and Virginia Tech's had a bunch of them.
That's 8 now. And they're almost to where they had combined against NC State and Virginia. They only turned it over 4 times in the upset of number 4 Virginia.
9 points off turnovers for Duke. And you know, if you are going to turn the ball over against them, you want it to be a dead ball turnover like this, so you have a chance to get back, set your defense, and you know, not give turnover near midcourt with it turns into points. Got himself buried in the corner on that rebound.
Tech. Seth Allen misses from close range, and it sets up the transition for Grayson Allen.
Well, and Devin Wilson did the smart thing and got out of the poster, but that's the explosiveness that he brings out there, and it's Duke's biggest lead.
It's all Duke at Cameron this afternoon. Luke Kennard didn't like the call, but he got called with a personal. Grayson Allen, bang! 43-20, Blue Devils. Let up. And for the first time this afternoon, Virginia Tech is shooting 1-1. Zach Ledet, the redshirt junior, transfer from down in the Sunshine State. He's got his first point of the afternoon.
And he comes in averaging 15 points a game. So that's, they need him to get involved in this offense.
He had 22 points against Virginia Monday, and he gets the roll on the second one.
You don't mind that. That was a well-designed
6 points.
That's a well-designed play. Thornton driving in, drawing the top of that zone down. Matt Jones coming right behind him for the three.
Ledet takes it himself.
I said you need to get involved in the offense, but I think a little bit of a push that time. Tried to do too much.
Jones picks up his dribble. No problem for Allen, who's always aggressive. Nice pass to Plumlee, that's knocked out of bounds. Don't forget, coming up next, fourth-ranked Virginia takes on Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech much improved this year.
They can they really can score the ball. They scored 83 points the last game out, but this is a big game for Virginia.
Duke turns it over. Yeah, Marcus Georges Hunt averages 15.
Charles Mitchell's inside.
Nick Jacobs averages 10. Charles Mitchell, you mentioned, he averages a double-double.
Yeah, that's Georgia Tech up at Pittsburgh, and Pitt creeping into the top 25 too. I think they were held back a little bit earlier this year. They did not have a great strength of schedule in their non-conference games.
We didn't expect this here this afternoon. We thought Virginia Tech would come in and test Duke a little bit at home. Seth Allen's shot went around the rim and came back out, did a victory lap, and Plumlee pulls the rebound. He's got 7 rebounds now, Plumlee does. Jones looks into the corner. Ingram wanted the shot. Oh, nice pass to Plumlee. How about the ball skills of Brandon Ingram?
Tim, he's two rebounds away from a double-double in the first half. For the rebound, and then he's really learned how to play off his other guys on the perimeter when they drive.
Great pass by Ingram. You know, they don't keep defensive stats for deflections, but Ingram gets a lot of them. He also gets a lot of assists. There's Seth Allen, makes that free throw. Reminder group coming up. Hardy's halftime report will help Duke celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Blue Devils' 1966 Final Four team and the 25th anniversary of the 1991 NCAA championship team. Championship Saturday here at Duke. All that plus highlight stats and a whole lot more coming up on the Hardy's halftime report. Ingram forces it up and still makes it for his 12th point.
Yeah, you can tell over the last few minutes Duke hasn't taken. Jones took a three, but it's been a lot of attacking the basket.
And Mike Krzyzewski still working the officials hard. Virginia Tech committed more than twice as many fouls as Duke has here this afternoon.
Well, the Clockerty family has heard a lot of Mike Krzyzewski in their ear.
No question.
John was a great longtime official in this league, now head of, his last year as head of officials.
That shot blocked starts the transition. Thornton pulls it back out. He's a good looking player. That'll get Virginia Tech going. Seth Allen's been fairly quiet here. There's a nice pass, but it's blocked away from behind by Ingram.
Fifth block of the half for Duke.
And Duke takes a timeout with 19.8 seconds to play in the first half.
Here's the look in the, you know, Blackshear thinks he's got a wide open layup, but the length. Tomorrow at noon, and of course Clemson playing in Greenville, South Carolina. The Coliseum there this year as Little John gets refinished.
Final 15 seconds of the first half. Well, they started lining up at 10:30 this morning, the Duke Crazies, and they have not been disappointed. Their team has played well here in the first half. Well, Bibbs was out in front of everybody. They didn't find him. He had time to get that layup. All they have to do is lay it out there. But what a first half by Brandon Ingram, the 6'9" freshman from Kinston, North Carolina. The Blue Devils big at the half, 50-23. We'll be back with our halftime activities after this. Is playing well. Take a look at some of the leading scorers and what they're doing today. Of course, Grayson Allen with that great transition move takes it right down Main Street. A lot of times strong to the hoop. 12 points, 4-9 from the field. Ingram got him going. Hit a couple of threes. He's got 12 points. They've got three guys in double digits already, Mike, first half.
And then you look at Virginia Tech and Allen, 1 of 6, 3 points. And Lade, 2 points, 0 of 3 from the floor. So their two main guys have not been a part of the offense.
That's an indication that Virginia Tech is going to try to force the action here. Jalen Hudson took it right at the basket. He was fouled. He'll go to the line. He scored 23 points in a win over NC State. They need some of his points right now. Just really having a tough time. 61% free throw shooter. He's got 5 points here today. Them both.
Yeah, so, and you knew I talked about it the first 4 or 5 minutes, critical for Virginia Tech to try to at least carve into the lead a little bit. Obviously not a great start.
Grayson Allen has it halfway down and comes back out.
Well, Allen was lucky. You can't go under a screen like that with that with Grayson Allen, too good of a shooter.
Talking about LeMay before the ball game, where he's hitting almost 60%. There's a nice pass inside to Shane Henry, who buries it. He's got 4 points. But LeMay was very quiet. He's hitting about 60% from beyond the arc, 59%.
Yeah, Lade, you look at him that time, and they came in double big right on the catch with Plumlee coming in, and at least Shane Henry read that correctly and dove to the basket. Plumlee taking a little shot in the eye. There's the look, and you see him posting up, and that's a big double team to pass out of. Plumlee very long, Ingram very long, but a nice play. One of the few really good offensive plays that Virginia Tech has had.
That foul is on Jalen Hudson. That's his third personal, so he continues to struggle on both ends of the floor.
Plumlee looking really good on his form. Perfect 6 of 6 from the line.
And it makes it a 52-25 ball game. Seth Allen for three. He's short. Plumlee with another rebound. He's having a good day. He's got 9 rebounds. He's going to have a double-double today. It's in the cards. Nice backdoor cut, nice pass. Here's Plumlee underneath. He's fouled. This foul looks like it'll be on Shane Henry. That's 3 on Henry. Henry's a psychology major, and right now he needs a checkup from the neck up.
Yeah, it's the match, and the growth of Marshall Plumlee. He's upset at himself now for missing shots and not finishing 3-point plays. Now he's expecting himself to score.
That's good.
That's a good thing.
Marshall Plumlee, 7 feet, 250-pound graduate student, Warsaw, Indiana. You know about their family. Looks good on that free throw. He's now 13 points. Played a terrific physical game at Wake Forest, and a lot of guys are saying, okay, well, that's when Devin Thomas was out of the game. But he played well. He really played well in that game, and they came away with a W. That whole game turned when Devin Thomas got that technical.
Yeah, and it's unfortunately, that's been an issue with him and his temper over the years.
Nice pass inside. Henry finishes, and they got a badly needed bucket.
Yeah, a couple of quick passes from him, and he's gotten it. One's just cutting down the rim. Basket on the double team. That time off the two-man game.
How about Matt Jones takes it right down and can't finish?
When they lift Plumlee high like that, there are a lot of driving lanes. That's a shot he normally finishes.
Grayson Allen takes it down the lane and loses it out of bounds.
That was a good call. It did go off his hands, but and I thought Allen again maybe a little bit too aggressive on that play, Tim. There were not numbers. You have to read that. Maybe wait for some friends coming back. This was a 1-on-3 break. And, Dan Allen saying that he got fouled too and looked like there was a little contact on the wrist.
Jalen Hudson. Boy, everybody hitting the floor. Five guys down. And Ingram lost his shoe. Well, here's today's trivia question. It's courtesy of Duke Energy. Since 2000, how many freshmen were selected on the preseason first team all ACC? We'll check back later in the game for the answer to that. Download more ACC trivia. It's powered by Duke Energy in your app store. Boy, a lot of guys on the floor on that play. Ingram lost his shoe. He's all back together. Ingram says, you come out of Kinston, North Carolina, you got to be tough on the court. Played for Jerry Stackhouse, AAU.
It's interesting to see how much, you know, if he can keep the weight on over the course of the season or if he can add to it. It's tough when the, you know, with the grind of 18 games.
Okay, so here's the situation now. Virginia Tech's basketball, but they only have 8 on the shot clock. So they've got to get into something quickly here.
You know, Taylor, when all the games that I've done up to this point, I haven't really seen the 30-second clock be an issue. I've seen 3 or 4 violations, which is about normal.
Seth Allen couldn't finish. Got the shot off in time. The baskets have been hard for Virginia Tech here this afternoon.
Well, after that explosion in the first half, Duke only 3 points in the first 3 minutes of this half.
Knocked out of bounds by Matt Jones. How about Coach K? He loves Matt Jones, doesn't he?
Yeah, I mean, he's had to be, you know, with Emile Jefferson out, he's had to be the leader and the rock of this team. And Plumlee's also stepped up, too, in that role.
There's a look at Emile Jefferson, the broken foot.
But at least now, and I understand that he's still, when he's out on campus and walking around, he wears a walking boot. But when he's at the practice facility, he's in sneakers. So that's a injury. And, Notre Dame off to a little bit slower start than I thought they would be. Ingram, of course, we talked about. Important game for Virginia down at Georgia Tech. And Kennedy is down at Florida State. At least he's got some help this year with the two freshmen, Bacon and Beasley.
We talk about Jefferson. He's certainly missed by this Duke team. Shot 65% from the field, but he struggled at the line. Never shot better than 60% at the free throw line. Inside to Hudson, and Hudson gets it to go down. 53-29. Hudson with 7 points.
Tech running a little bit better half court offense to start off.
Oh, what a nice drive by Derek Thornton, the freshman from California. He's got 5 points.
That's the thing, that Tech is lacking no real shot blocker out there, so you don't have to be looking around for guys.
Allen kicks it back out to Hudson. Hudson in the lane is fouled before the shot. That foul is going to be on Grayson Allen, and that's 2 on Allen. Mike Krzyzewski. Yeah, it's hard to get going when it's 55-29. The crowd's just kind of yawning.
Yeah, but if you're Virginia Tech, that's exactly what you want.
Yeah,
you
know, absolutely.
You hope that you wouldn't think that the team out on the court would get complacent, but at least quiet the crowd down. And Ryder trying to draw the foul that time, but Plumlee holding his ground, keeping his arms up, and finishing with a block.
Just been a tough day offensively and defensively for the Hokies. This ball's kicked out of bounds, and it belongs to the Blue Devils.
Well, today still no made field goals in this game.
A look at Zach Lede, the 6'7", 235-pounder from Dallas, transfer from Florida. It's started his Hokie career with 26 points and 15 rebounds against Alabama State. That was the first time he put on a Hokie uniform.
And I think that's where that's the one everybody they lost that game. And then everybody, I think everybody kind of gave up on Virginia Tech early, but they've come back pretty strong.
There's a turnover by Duke. 15:55 to play. It's still Duke big.
Are you okay, Mom?
Yes, I am.
What's it doing today?
Good. I'm guessing the hay's in the barn. You guys are sitting back this week, getting healthy, getting some rest, and rejuvenating, ready for next week.
Most certainly. You know, we had a good week of practice. I'm pretty excited about our guys getting a little time off.
Hey, Ron, I know that, you know, this week is going to be incredibly intensive in the preparation for whoever you have to play. Are you going to have an eye on the national championship game tomorrow night, though?
Oh, we will. You know, it's one of those things that, you know, we're in a good position. We've had a good work week. We've got a lot of preparation done for the most part. Once we find out who our opponent is, then we'll put the rest of the game plan together.
How do you feel about your secondary right now? You got some new guys in there. Were they able to get some reps this last week in practice, and will they continue this week?
Almost certainly. You know, very excited about it. You know, we picked up Robert McLean, and he's done a nice job for us in place of Peanut Tillman. So, you know, we expect him to continue to develop in our system. And Cortland Finnegan has been an outstanding find for us at the nickel position for us.
Ron, talk about the growth of both Cam and Luke, offense and defense. I mean, what a turnaround from last year, and those two guys certainly have been the leaders.
Very much so. You know, I think the neat thing that has happened for us is, you know, we found the franchise players on both sides of the ball, and they've really developed as individuals. But more importantly, they're making the players around them better, and that's what you need from great players.
Well, Ron, thanks for joining us as Grayson Allen gets the crowd going. 15-1. We wish you all the best. Good luck in the NFL playoffs.
Well, I appreciate it, guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good luck. Hey, Coach Rivera comes on, and we get a breakaway dunk. Duke gets up.
He's going to put Grayson Allen in that secondary. He keeps that up.
No question. I mean, Charlotte was so consumed with the Panthers this year, and you know, with good reason.
Justin Bibbs got a good look and silenced the crowd with a short jumper. 58-31. Boy, that's nice of Coach to come on with us.
Yeah, again, good to see that this is probably a very good, relaxing get out of town for a little bit day.
I remember when he played college ball. Wow, good play. Grayson Allen misses the three. Henry goes high to get the rebound and starts it going the other way. Justin Bibbs has another look but can't knock it down.
That's one thing that Duke has been very good at over the years, Tim, to taking primary scorers out of it. And the three guys who averaged double figures for Virginia Tech have been effectively shut down in this game.
14:25 to go in the ball game. That's a two. Makes it 58-33. Seth Allen's been quiet, only has 5 points. Jason Allen right there.
I see the nice look ahead right there. Really know we talked about how transition defense was going to be a big key, and not good balance defensively getting back.
Shane Henry picks up his fourth personal. Ingram goes to the line and draws iron. Grayson Allen, people say, hey, he's just a little guy. How does he get up and dunk like that? He's 6'5".
Well, no, if you stand near him down in the court, he's bigger than he
absolutely
appears. He's very athletic.
Stands next to these 6'9", 10 guys, 7-footers. Sure, he's going to look a little, but he's 6'5". Under 14 minutes to play. Clock continues to move. Time running out on the Hokies. Seth Allen working against Jones. Gives it to Henry. Tough turnaround. They can't get it. Duke does.
Nice save by Ingram. Again, his length serving him well that time.
No question, Buzz Williams has had an impact at Virginia Tech this year, though, and last. He's turning that program around.
Yeah, he's going to build a winner there, and I thought that was an outstanding hire by Virginia Tech when they were able to get him away from Marquette.
Won the Big East regular season championship in 2013. Came to Virginia Tech and immediately set his goals very, very high there. Blacksburg. Take a look around the ACC from Progressive Insurance. Of course, today we've been talking about the Virginia Georgia Tech game coming up at 2 o'clock. Pitt Notre Dame should be fun to watch. Mike Bray trying to get that Irish team together, as you said.
Big big game for Florida State. 0-2 right now, and Miami's only played one league game at this point.
How about the job by Jim Larrañaga?
You know what? I mean, it's like, you know. A lot of, you know, this Duke team has been very young the last few years. The Miami team seems to always be old. Like they always have guys who are, you know, in their, you know, 21, 22 grad students, fourth year juniors, fifth year seniors, and they've got a terrific backcourt in Rodriguez and McClellan.
Remember now, that's what Jim took to the Final Four when he was at George Mason. That was an experienced team.
And that's what he won the ACC championship with. That's what the last four ACC champions have been.
Yeah, they have.
Teams.
Yeah, they have. In this era of one and dones, it makes a difference, too. LeMay. Nice stop. Jump. 2 points. He's got 6 for the afternoon. If you're just joining us, Duke got off to a great start. They hit 4 threes to start the game, went 4 for 4 beyond the arc. And as Mike said, Virginia Tech found themselves down in double digits before they were a couple steps off the bus.
Today, that time, end to end, nobody really stopped the ball. And Mike Krzyzewski wanted a
against Virginia Monday night. And he has been a factor, as Mike said, averaging 15 points, 10 rebounds a game. He just had the last 6 for Virginia Tech. Don't forget, coming up, 4th-ranked Virginia down in Atlanta taking on Georgia Tech. Good tip back, gets it back to Duke.
Nice play by Jeter that time, and that's what the Duke bigs over the years have done that repeatedly. If they can't get the offensive rebound, they tip it back out.
Jalen Hudson almost had a steal. Banged his head pretty good on Coach K's court, too. We'll be back. Back to play. First possession. Duke comes up empty, and Virginia Tech will go the other way. Since Virginia Tech joined the Atlantic Coast Conference, Mike, they're 2-2 against Duke in the regular season, but trail in the overall series 44-8.
Well, I've had a had their hearts broken here too by I think it was Daniel Ewing. He hit a bomb from half court to win the game.
Take a look at the AP top 25. Virginia 4th.
Be interested to see with North Carolina when Kennedy Meeks comes back, how that you know, impacts their team. And Mike specifically talked about Miami today and where he thought they were in the hierarchy. He really likes their team.
Shot clock violation.
Be seeing a history in the making here. 0 of 11 today in the game.
Have to go all the way back to the game against Providence. Last game without a 3-pointer. Buzz Williams still working. Vest still on.
I think we got it under double figures. That got to get under double figures with the vest. Might come off.
This is a walk by Grayson Allen. And so they'll go the other way. That doesn't make Mike very happy. The officials today, Tim Clockerty, Jeffrey Anderson, and Wally Witecki.
He's really slowed down for Duke offensively in this second half. 15 points in 10 minutes. They've been a little bit more deliberate in the half court, trying to run a little clock.
Justin Robinson in the ball game for the Hokies, and he gives them a little bit more speed. He's a talented freshman for Virginia Tech. played 24 minutes the other night, Monday night against the Wahoos, and he had 6 assists. This foul will be
Thornton on the weak side.
Derek Thornton. That's 3 on Thornton.
And they've had guys come in. If Thornton gets in foul trouble or needs a break, they've got the, you know, Grayson Allen, and even Matt Jones has run the point a little bit.
Seth Allen struggling the way he did today. His mom's sick. His dad's down here at the game. She usually goes to every game. Had a nice talk with him beforehand. But he goes out of the ball game, and with Justin Robinson in the game now, it gives him fresh legs, gives him that freshman who wants to put a little energy in this team.
And then, you know, not saying that Buzz Williams has, you know, risen the white flag at this point, but you know, a chance for him to get some really good court time.
Yeah, no question about it. And for Seth Allen, it's a chance to rest those legs, because he plays almost every minute of every game. He's their Iron Man.
It's just been just one of those nights for one of those days for him in the ACC. 1 of 9 shooting 3 points.
Jalen Hudson. This is the second, so he stays at 8 points. Nice follow underneath by Lede, and he's fouled. Zach Lede now will go to the line.
Much more active offensively in the second half. Good board work that time.
Zach Lede, 6'7" from Dallas, Texas. He's got some quick elevation.
Yeah, it does a lot for him too. Not just the reboundings in the shot, but also 22 blocks. With a technical foul on
here's a bench warning. You saw Buzz Williams talking to Tim Clackerty, and so now they're going to get a bench warning because he, I guess, kept chirping. Crowd starts chanting, "Sit, Buzz, sit."
I probably think he's not going to listen to that.
No, but I guarantee you, Coach Williams has certainly caused a buzz down in Blacksburg and throughout the ACC.
Well, I haven't been here, and you know, his Seth Greenberg, right from the start, embraced Cameron Indoor Stadium, loved coming down here and competing, and the atmosphere. And I think that Buzz Williams probably feels the same.
I think most coaches feel that way. Love the atmosphere. I can't say they love to play here. Boy, the Blue Devils are some kind of good in this building. Always have been. Although Mike Krzyzewski would beg to differ his first year. That ball by Derek Thornton went halfway down and came back out. Pass ahead. Blackshear knocks it down and slams it.
Well, it's rare that you see a team just on a missed shot get a run out like that and a dunk. Blackshear really showing the ability to change ends of the floor well.
Gets the crowd back in the game. Coach K thought it was getting too quiet in here. Call that offensive on Derek Thornton.
Here's the look. Decent job stepping over. Thornton looked a little bit out of control on that play.
This is a 9-0 Virginia Tech run. That's why the crowd's getting back into it, trying to get the team awake again. Hudson left-handed, can't get it to go. Fight for the rebound. Tech keeps it alive. Hudson again.
Yeah, you can see his feet slid out a little bit underneath him. Really hustled. Plumlee coming up a little gimpy.
Hey, 8:51 to play. Gave that 9-0 run has given us a little shot of adrenaline here. Crowd back on its feet, cheering Duke on.
Virginia Tech sitting back in the zone a little bit. They're trying to invite Duke to take a three.
Matt Jones dribbles into trouble. Ball's loose. Here's a foul. Going to call his spirit foul on Blackshear.
That's three. You remember, Tim, early in the first half that Duke got into the penalty. Both teams sitting on six personal fouls right now.
Matt Jones calls out the offense. They start to run it again. Shot clock hadn't been a factor all day, and Plumlee takes it in low and banks it in.
Well, against the zone, and he just had Blackshear buried on his back deep in the paint.
He's got 15 points. ...67-44 in a game of unbeatens.
Marshall Plumlee
coming into this game in the ACC
with a double-double.
15 points, 10 rebounds. What an afternoon for Marshall. Wilson comes away with a loose ball, pushes it up. Kick it out. LeDay had a look. Instead, he goes back to Wilson and takes it down the lane with the big fellas. And the follow is good. Good job by Zach LeDay to stay with it. He's got 14 points. Will be noon. They've enjoyed themselves, getting a little bored now. 7:29 to play in a game and 67-46 Blue Devil lead. Don't forget, coming up next, fourth ranked Virginia takes on Georgia Tech. That's down to Camish, down in Atlanta. Ingram, he's been quiet for a long stretch here after getting the Blue Devils out in a hurry in this ball game this afternoon, and the ball's going to stay right down at Duke's end.
That's pretty stout since the 04-05 season. Of course, I've had the privilege of calling a game in Allen Fieldhouse, and that's another, it's a place that's like Cameron on steroids. It holds about 16,000-17,000 there, and that is a rabid fan base as well.
Blackshear picks up his fourth personal. Plumlee just knocks it down. One and one situation. See the time remaining in this ball game. Duke trying to go to 14-2 and 3-0 in the ACC.
You love the balance of the scoring. Four of the five starters for Duke with double figure points, and Matt Jones sitting at 8.
You know, you talked about it coming into the ball game. We were talking before the game even started. You're talking about Plumlee and how he has been so solid the last couple of weeks, and here again this afternoon gives you a top rate performance. Blackshear way too strong over the rack. Duke comes away with it. Dangerous pass. Hudson almost had it, and it was the last touch by Grayson Allen.
Matt Jones is a little casual with that pass on the wing.
That's 13 turnovers for Duke.
And this is a team that normally takes very good care. They average 9.8 turnovers, one of the best in the country. Just a little casual with the ball on some possessions.
Virginia Tech gives it right back to him. Whistle and foul away from the basketball down underneath. That's going to be on Zach LeDay, and that's his fourth personal.
Yeah, they're trying to run a little screening action to let Ingram work down into the post area.
Too strong, bounced around and came back out. He's only a 64% free throw shooter. Blackshear, Blackshear looked at it.
Right, LeDay.
I thought it went off LeDay's forehead, but
Grayson Allen did a pretty good job of it. He got caught in a little bit of a switch, and Lede trying to post up inside, but Allen able to fight around him.
Seth Allen back in the ball game. Nice pass, mishandled. Boy, that was a great pass, but Blackshear couldn't handle it.
Well, he was dunking the ball before he ever caught it, and that was the problem. You got to catch it first and then finish.
Here it is again. Take a look at this.
There's the two-man game, the pick and roll, and he just was trying to score before he ever corralled the ball.
That's 14 turnovers for the Hokies. You saw the reaction of Seth Allen. Seth Allen, quality guy.
You can tend now to run some clock, go down about 12 or 11, and then start the play.
Crowd lets him know it is, and Plumlee's right there with the emphatic finish. 19 points for Marshall Plumlee.
Impressive number of those. Now, you know, the dunks, you know he's going to finish those, but 9 of 10 from the free throw line.
Blackshear just looks uncomfortable anytime he's in the neighborhood of the basketball.
Well, as a freshman, your first trip to Cameron, it can be a little unnerving, but this is what Mike Krzyzewski talked about. Without Jefferson, they just spread the floor so well, and Plumlee is just able to run free inside and play off of drives.
Justin Robinson at the line, shooting 1-1 for Virginia Tech. Doesn't earn the second one. Well, Allen's got such a great first step.
And you know what? Early on, he used to be strictly a right-handed driver, but he's worked more on his left hand recently and finishing that way. And conversely, Kennard, a left-hander, has done a little bit more work going right-handed.
Talking about balanced scoring? Yeah. How about that?
You think if, unless he comes out, that Matt Jones might find two more points in there somewhere to make a fifth starter as a double-figure scorer.
Grayson Allen picks up his fourth personal. Four guys in double figures, that'll win you a lot of games. Grayson Allen to go out with those four personals. Take a seat on the Duke bench. Robinson makes a free throw, earns the second one.
Well, and you know, Mike Krzyzewski knows there's that balance between, you know, you got the game in hand right now. You only have 7 guys, but you want to try to spread the minutes of rest around as much as you can and try to save legs out there.
Nice job over the last few minutes by Virginia Tech, continuing to play hard. Look at Plumlee with the left-handed hook. Who is this guy?
Unrecognizable to the player I saw 3 or 4 years ago.
21 points, that's a career high for Marshall Plumlee. Robinson for 3.
Well, that streak continues of a made 3. That's their first one of the game.
And they start to chant Marshall Plumlee.
Well, there's your fifth starter in double figures.
Matt Jones, fifth Duke player in double figures, is right. Blackshear looks at it, takes it in, turn around, little jump hook is good.
You know, it's actually Virginia Tech is winning this half 30-27. It just got buried too deeply too early.
First 3 minutes.
Yeah. all those threes, and Duke hasn't hit many threes since that.
What we say after they hit those first four straight, they went 3-15.
Well, they're chanting his name, and what an afternoon he's had. A career high for 7-footer Marshall Plumlee. It's always special to come in this place. What an afternoon by Marshall Plumlee. The 7-foot graduate student has a career high 21 points today. He's been all over the boards as well, offensively and defensively. He's got 10 rebounds. And they were chanting his name as we went to commercial break. Robinson penetrates and gets fouled. This foul will be on Chase Jeter. And how about Brandon Ingram? He had our Chevy performance of the game today, brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. 14 points, 8 rebounds, and 6 blocks. The biggest thing he did there, Mike, was got them out of the gates in a hurry.
Yeah, and he's a nice rim protector there alongside Plumlee. And talk about good minutes. I mean, these are good minutes for Chase Jeter out on the floor.
Don't forget, coming up next, you've got 4th-ranked Virginia taking on Georgia Tech.
And, Ingram looks a little fatigued out on the floor. Logged a lot of minutes today.
Ingram drives the lane, tries to bank it in, gets fouled. So Ingram go to the line. As you look at Buzz Williams, came into this building this afternoon, 43 years old. I bet he feels older right now. Makes the free throw. Duke raced to a 12-2 lead and never looked back. They've dominated this ball game, and this kid right here, Brandon Ingram, the freshman from Kinston, North Carolina, is some kind of special. He's got 15 points.
And the amazing thing, you know, you still look at him and he's thin, but he's put on 25-20 pounds since he's come on campus in the summer. He gets a well-deserved curtain call.
I almost said so did I. Well, freshman 30.
He could use yours too.
Day takes it down the lane. He's fouled by Jeter. That's two quick ones on Chase Jeter. He now has 4 for the game. He's had 2 real quick here. This is the game coming up next on many of the ACC network stations. Check your local listings. Day buries that one for 15 points now.
We also have some mobile viewership out there. I got a shout from my teammate Kenny Denard. He was in his motor coach somewhere in Texas watching the game, and I know we're all affected by the passing of Coach Foster. I know those two had a very special relationship, as we all did.
Bill Foster passed away Thursday, 86 years old. One of the great members of the Duke family, won 113 games during the 6 years here before he moved on to South Carolina.
This is over for Coach McGuire there. Big shoes to fill. Took 4 teams to the NCAA tournament.
Speaking of South Carolina, just got a little text from Bobby Kremens. Good to hear from Bobby. Always good to hear from Bobby.
He recruited me. Show me how old he is and how old I am. He recruited me out of high school for Frank McGuire down in South Carolina.
Bobby Kremens?
Yep. Line of Duke.
He didn't do a very good job.
Just kidding, Coach, if you're listening.
He's watching this. Well, the final minute and a half. As we said at halftime, Duke delivered a knockout punch in that first half. And Virginia Tech was unable to get off the canvas and really make a run. And kicks it back. Hudson fouled. Jalen Hudson will go to the line. Don't forget the national championship coming up Monday night, 8:30 start time there. How about it? Alabama, Clemson.
Who do you like? I'll tell you what, it's tough to bet against Nick Saban. I mean, their defense is so good. Deshaun Watson is going to have to play above great, I think, for them to win. And but I know that it's going to be interesting to see the buzz around the Clemson game tomorrow in anticipation of that on Monday night.
Yeah, I agree. I was fortunate enough to announce the first Clemson game this past season. Their opener down at Death Valley, and they were ranked 12th going into the season. I said they were underrated then. They're right where they should be, but I still think Clemson wins it. And I think that they'll find some way with a speed on defense to stop Derrick Henry.
Well, that would be an incredible accomplishment for the league. Really enhance its profile. You
know, yeah, absolutely.
The league has had its naysayers in football. Florida State, the last team to win the national championship in the ACC, correct?
That's correct.
Yeah, a couple of years. And I think Mark Richt, a great hire down at Miami too. See him get that program turned around.
Thrilled to be back at his alma mater. Final 20 seconds of this one here. Again, Duke raced to that 12-2 lead, never looked back, led by as many as 30. In complete control of this one. Final 13 seconds. How about that? Put an exclamation on it.
That's how the game started, and that's how the game will end.
That's it. Mike Krzyzewski's Blue Devils go to 14-2. We'll be back after this.
You could be the best in your house.
And then your state.
And get all the